was involved in, and the questions I hope my colleague Artus, who is our project manager, will help. Actually, he was leading this project. Project is already completed, so now we can take a look at this. But I don't like to start with the ending, and the ending is the project, or in some cases, even start of the project. Proceed, please. Okay, we already started about the formal approach. In that case, I'd like to make a few looks at the waterfall. I think it looks nice. We already mentioned about those steps. What we know? Okay, here could be a different situation. Sometimes we say there are more steps. In some cases, some steps are passed over because it's not important. I just reminding about steps. Why? Because this is the main difference. When and how and what to use. The main thing is why. We a lot are talking about the situation waterfall versus agile. Who's better, who's stronger, who's smarter, what we like most. We fail. All of us. Why? Because in that case I would say, did everyone got today dinner? Okay, please raise hands who got dinner today. I got. Okay, nice, thank you much. Lunch. I think we're gonna eat maybe this evening more. What we are using or will be using? Knife, fork, spoon? What are those? Those are tools. Kind of project methodologies. Why? Because our supper, dinner, it's a project. And if we take some soup, then fork would not be the best tool. And having a large potato, or maybe some kind of meat, I would not recommend using spoon. But still, we can complete the project with spoon or fork, or even with those knife sticks. Oh, not me. That's a bottle. And here we come to the main question: why and when to use what, not what is it? Mainly, we in mind have some kind of meaning, what I think, what is waterfall and what is agile, but how to choose? What I propose is to look at this. What is the main thing when I think it's waterfall? Waterfall, it means I can't easily step back. I can't easily fix my mistakes. It's gonna cost me a lot. In agile, oh, it's great! I can correct, as a matter of fact, almost in any minute of the project. How I see, the first one is made a large cannon, what we are shooting, as example, from Europe to America. And precise targeting, and then we shoot! And fail to change something when ball is flying. As agile, we have radio, transmitter, rocket. We are targeting it. We still can, but we can still fail, and a lot of fail. It means what you have and why. Waterfall makes some guarantees to you that you can't step back. Okay, it's wrong, but it's feeling inside, and mostly for stakeholders. They feel sure that when I make step forward, I'm not falling back. Okay, it's wrong, but they feel this way. As agile, oh, it's great, I have this movement, I'm going to go, but I'm afraid that I will be making circles. And there's no way to prove for me, because I'm afraid, it's irrational. How I can choose and what to do? Choose wisely. Work with your customer, learn. First, as I'm talking about the waterfall, I will say, not stick to waterfall. When we need to react yesterday, it means it's already broke.
broken, people's dying, you can't go with waterfall way. You have no time. You start helping them, rescuing, then you make some processes, correct, rescue more, great. If you go by waterfall, okay, we rescue one. Everyone else died. Oh yes, I see, you see, some projects died. The next situation is long-term projects, especially in IT. It means, okay, we mark when we want to go. All is changing. There's no such place anymore. Project is for 2 years, 3 years maybe. When we reach those 2 or 3 years, this place doesn't exist anymore. So we got to the requirements, but as a matter of fact, there's no such goals anymore. It means waterfall processes fail from the start. Because we know we're gonna change in the way. If situation requires shortest possible delivery. Yes, it kind of sticks with React now, but there could be situations when we need to make some small parts and to keep business alive. We need to deliver those now, fast, or we'll be out of business. It's for the customer. And what is, I would say, recommended solution, if you are creating prototype, okay, could be waterfall, but probably not, because in the process, I think you're gonna learn, you're gonna change, make it more appropriate, and then actually will be better. But there's still situations when someone is happy with those formal approach. When and why? We can't start next step before previous steps are complete. As an example I was given, it's not my example, it's if you are building, oh yes, before you clear the place, you can't build something up. Before structure is built, you can't make inside electricity, put windows in place, it's not gonna work out. Okay, it's a kind of sample, but look at this. If you can't start next step before previous are complete, okay, better keep with waterfall. Because waterfall says, yes, it's right, you have to do it this way. Mm-hmm. Even more interesting thing is if the last step are the most costly one. It means you don't want to go through all steps, pay a lot of cash for last step, and then see, agile way, okay, it wasn't so good, let's change, but you already paid. Paid a lot. It means you want to make it maximize precise where you are going before, because every next step costs twice as previous step or three times as previous step. So you don't want to make wrong steps. Specific, but it happens.
Can you give examples in software? Not about building, but examples in software when it is.
And every next step is more? Okay, we have...
When you can't step back, so...
Yeah, you can step back every time, but what it costs, as example, for those. Okay, you are making the main project. You're a smart guy, you have smart team, great, but organization requirements, you complete description and give it away to those not so smart ones. It's next step. You can't control them.
When it comes to stupid organization, then we need to use waterfall.
No, it's specific because costs are reduced. At the final stage, Chinese and Indians will be making it, and you have no control over the project. They will be paying 10,000 in China to make this last one piece. Well, you make an idea, describe.
I guess someone can argue that whoever decided to go with Chinese might have decided to go agile way with agile Chinese.
It depends on organizations. There's no one right answer. Even more, we should look this way. This is the one end, waterfall. This is the second end, agile. And mostly we are somewhere in the middle.
Good example would be if you need to translate your system like into 20 languages, then you want to do it only when it's a completed functionality in one language, only then start translating, like not to give to translators like every version and pay
again. Fast delivery, you need to translate the small one already, give it away, have a feedback. It's different. It's not so easy to say, okay, this project 100% falls in this. No. Those make as a checkpoint, checkboxes. You check, okay, this project is kind of this, and as an agile, this. Where's more? Choose. Even more, okay, you probably like it. Last one, bad thing about us, and I think mostly about us, unfortunately. I'm sorry to say it about me. Why we are making project? What we want? We want to make a great solution, reach the goal, equality, to be proud of it, and we fail. Why? Because all we want as developer to earn money from this project as a fund. Yes, as a person, I want all I mentioned before. But as a business, as a stakeholder, not as a customer, as a developer, stakeholder. Proper methodology to earn money, and we fail with our wanting this quality and everything like that. Sorry, this way
like
it works!
Do you speak of yourself?
Yes, me too, unfortunately.
I don't share your
problem. We disagree.
I'm a developer and I don't agree with your values.
You mean about money?
Yeah,
I'm not
so
a stakeholder. I'm not a stakeholder, but I got a point.
Yeah.
Hell.
But that's very short-sighted approach. The money is
the only driver. There's... Okay, it's nice to have this way of thinking, but it's more in personal part to have this feeling in personal that it's important of the quality and other things. But as a matter of fact, we should remember and don't forget any time money makes all this movement. And requirements are to get something. Customer signed to pay us if we complete the requirements, even unsigned. As a customer, want to feel good at the end of the project. And what is agile is better than waterfall. All agile knows it and concentrates to make it feel. And in agreement, there's no such line. Make customer feel happy. Waterfall says, whatever, you're gonna be there, you said you'll be happy. I don't say it's okay, I know you change your mind, let's discuss this. This is a hard planning what I was making last few years. I was thinking too, I want to make Rolls Royce, I want to make a lifetime guarantee for things I made. I feel this way, really. And I got to learn that, unfortunately, first I have to make guarantees for money, and then if I make them, I can do it whatever way I can. This is the hard part for the business manager. If manager are able to do it, team will be happy. Because manager coaches part of the money, okay?
Yeah, just to kind of get back on track on agile versus waterfall, because
we are still there.
Yeah, but we're just on
you mean this?
No. We just went on the money issue now. You can keep the same slide. So I have a question because the slide that you were showing when you were talking about with the happy elephant. So the question is, I basically could find holes in every statement why you should stick with waterfall, and I guess I think majority of the people here are from agile community. So the question is, those people that are heavily working with waterfall, can you give some kind of concrete examples? I know that you can think of elaborate examples why you need to where every step costs more and so on. Have you had anything like that in practice where you can say, yeah, this one where we should definitely stick to waterfall?
Let's get to the project. We're on the way.
Okay.
I can give one
project sample, as a matter of fact, I am not fond of waterfall. It's different parts, so I don't want to argue with you, I just need to do it. I'm gonna do it.
Okay, one additional part is changing environment. It means teams change so frequently. So if you don't have the formal approach, you don't have documentation, you are losing time. Because it's hard to keep going, because personnel are changing too frequently. Yes, it's kind of specific situation, but it happens. As example, there's no member who's more than 5 days on project. Try to do it agile. It will be hard.
It will be hard for any project as well.
Yes, but as a formal there's description, keep doing it. It's kind of making parts in factory. Come, take this, pull this, work. Go on.
Software is not a factory.
As a matter of fact, project methodologies are not only for IT.
Well, so we are discussing about software development today, right?
Yes, I'm trying to make a kind of provocation. Make you feel differences, not to make you comfortable.
We're trying to kind of respond to your
Let's postpone response till the end, maybe. So I can draw a full picture. And then you can throw tomatoes at this picture and step aside. Okay, I'm slightly over time already. One more. Steps are really separated as a different organizations. The central part makes one thing, takes you into another country, then you go to the next country. It's really hard work, agile level, because for agile communication is the goal. Yes?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. And now the bad part. It's irrational part. If stakeholder or the customer are afraid of changes, risks, or responsibilities, you're gonna really hardly selling agile way for them. Because they are afraid of the project itself. Any kind of methodology. The waterfall makes them feel more comfortable. You can sell agile, but it will be
if they don't need result, well then...
They need result, but they are afraid to change anything.
Software development is always about change.
So what?
So if they are afraid to do the project...
Yes, but need. Otherwise business will fail. But it's the approach of the customer, so they feel, I still want this one large button to press and everything will be right. It's not gonna happen. You need to change.
Happened,
that
we achieved good results.
With
such cases.
One button or with this?
Customers are afraid to change, afraid of responsibility.
Look at our government.
So are they successful?
They are still there. In some way, I say I'm more than successful. Guaranteed waterfall process. Once in a year, we make buttons, they're still there. Kind of problem with methodology. Okay, let's keep going or asking. So, what was this project I was meaning to talk about? It was update for healthcare data. It was first project I'm not talking about, already having the software solution. And what was the goals the customer were willing to achieve? They have some problems with search results, means they are not too well focused. They want to even to improve this function for search, improve usability, what means really hard part, because usability is always a hard. They want to improve response time, which is more technical requirement, can be achieved in different ways. Project took place last year, scheduled and completed in 8 months. So the fact. What are the next facts? What was the project prerequisites? It means what was before starting the project. First of all, strange, but all requirements were described very precisely from customer before project. They already did it. Why? Don't know. So it just was. Yes, it doesn't happen too often.
Was it including the usability improvement part?
Sorry?
Was it you said that all the requirements were described. Was the usability improvement precisely described as well?
Yes.
How it was described?
It's written in some samples.
For example, we want this functionality to work better.
Precisely, it meant there was samples of forms, how they should look and why they will work better.
So how do they know that they would work better in that way?
As they were made their part of analysis forms.
So they can make, so you can analyze usability.
Oh, it's long, but it's not going to happen in this evening. Usability are for weeks, not for just one evening, so we can't stick with this. Okay, even more nice, human resources for project from customer side was in time frame predefined. It means this person who's responsible will be available from this time till this. This person will be available from this till this. No changes available. You can work this way or don't. Give it away to someone else. Back payment. Even more, they were preparing it for a long time, and changes will take acceptance to long time, so it can be short and fast change to make some corrections in the project. Customer are located not in Latvia, not in Baltia, and what is more nice for every project manager, fixed time frame and budget. Wouldn't we like it? What could be more technical?
And no, the next one.
Oh yes, team is level of rotation and place. It means as the time frame was defined, the person changes, and is that some persons respond for same things. Now it's him in 2 weeks, and there will be different person responding for. Yes, this is nice.
On the customer side.
Yes.
Why?
You could ask them, but they will not respond. They're just asking, are you doing it or not? We're gonna play this way, with you, or with you, or with someone else. We don't care.
Traditional is stupid customer, right?
No, customer is never stupid, customer as it is. More likely, treat them as patients. Care for them with love, and take money from them.
You are mean.
Yes, I am. I'm still alive. That's why I'm me. Okay, and as a matter of fact, what happened? Those were prerequisites. Next thing, when to prove, was it right to stick with waterfall or not, is what was happening on the project. Because maybe prerequisites was nice for one methodology, and in time you see, okay, starting was good, but now we are working quite differently because we want to make changes on the process. It wasn't. Because really they are making changes only as a long life cycle. It means they can't change in the part. In 8 months it's almost nothing. It's too short. One change in 8 months. Nice life cycle. Communication problem took its place. Means response time. Means there's no way to agilely discuss the problems. No way. Even more, typically a customer was monitoring how the project is going, not by what is achieved or what they can get, but by the schedule. At this point, this should be ready. It is or not. We're not going to try it out. We're going to try it out at the end of the project. Now, it should be yes, no, yes. Nice, we're on the track. Feeling great? Yes, but as a fact, risk very high to fail. Yes, but so it was. And what failed? There was a mistake by chosen technology, and we were not able to implement what was mean to. And that wasn't waterfall, it was changing agile way. We got to the customer, we reached the right persons and agreed to change. Waterfall doesn't agree with this way. We have to fall back, make changes, get some through steps again, and go forward. But it would destroy the time frame. as we see, waterfall for this project was appropriate and was right. What it gives to us as a feeling is, if in Agile you feel this movement, you feel what you are making, you feel where you're going, and you have feeling it will be right, because you can get feedback from customers. The waterfall, there was different part, what could you get, and you got it. It's feeling of full control, not precisely with, as a GPS, where you are, from where you came, and precisely what is your next step, and where you are going. And it was through the project.
You said that you changed the technology code, so that's kind of a contradiction of what you just said.
As I said, it's where waterfall.
So that you didn't know exactly all the time, so what you were doing.
99% I got to you.
So when did you change that technique? Roughly percentage how much of the project was completed when you changed the technology?
Sorry? At what stage?
So when was the decision made to change this technology?
Because we announced that
in the beginning, the middle.
So how did you manage to still make it in time?
We just at the beginning of the development announced that solution that's preferred by the customer didn't work out.
So initially you knew precisely that you will do it with the first technology, and you precisely calculated how many hours and seconds it will take to use that technology, as you said. And then in the middle you change this technology, and still all the estimates and actual work remain precisely the same to the second. Hope it could happen.
It's part of risk management, where you're making some additional time change in the waterfall.
So you knew exactly, so that after 3 months and 18 days, you will make exactly this technology change decision.
We should talk about this on the open space.
I assume you made it in those 8 months, am I right?
Yes.
Okay, so the question, if it was halfway through and you had to trace back, so did you double the amount of people, or how did you manage still to...
The search function was one of the functions. It's not a big part.
Okay, so it's just a minor.
Yeah, it's a task for, I don't know.
It was the fail of the core.
Okay.
Yeah.
So if we state it a bit different way, that in some time in project you would make a step in waterfall way, that in this step we will have 1 week to research which technology is best for this search function. And after this week decide, okay, we go this one way or another way or third way. So basically that's what happened. But it was not planned exactly this way, but that's what happened.
Yeah, in project we had some a little buffer and we used it. So, few days.
So basically, if you initially like identify potential like technology risks that whatever, you in waterfall would make some points where you would make decisions that from this point on we go one way or another.
Question. You mentioned that change was made in agile way because there was no time and so on. What can you kind of explain what you mean by that? What would be the proper waterfall way to make the change comparing to the way you did it? I guess it's a part of a bigger question. I would like to ask your explanation, what exactly you mean by this agile and what you mean by waterfall, because that's it's very fundamental to understand when you say one against another, what you mean by each of these.
When you get to development, it's not time to change one architecture, whereas it's a decision for technology. It means you fall back, you recheck all technologies, and if there was some more steps, you proceed through them again, and only then you get again to development. In Agile, well, you just make changes at the point where you are, make some small life cycle inside this, but all other projects keeping its way on.
So So, did you update the project plan because of this change? Did you update some architecture documents because of this change? Or some design documents?
Yes, that's the computation was updated.
Well,
but
so...
It doesn't took so many time as you might imagine.
So, then...
No, but I think what we're talking about is kind of this uber extreme agile and uber extreme waterfall. So, in terms of these of this comparison, the way to make change with waterfall is not to make the change. So, but when you're working in the real environment, I mean, even if you're saying we're working according to the waterfall, still you don't go halfway during the project. If you have a minor change, all the steps back and retrace them, still you do it kind of on the fly. So I think it's more of an idealized discussion versus the real world discussion.
Well, that's why I asked, what do you mean by waterfall? I mean, is waterfall, in your opinion, and maybe in the opinion of audience, is that no change at all? Is that what people understand by word waterfall?
Well, I guess we will continue to discuss this question at Open Space. We are quite short in our whole time of our event, so I guess we have to thank Andris. Well, 10 minutes break, and we will continue with the other part.